y'all feeling? And the response is blessed, right? Because we're always blessed, especially when you're starting off something new like this. I've never done this before. I've never showed up in your living room. I've never even recorded anything like this before. And maybe for you, this is a new experience too. You're in somebody's house that you haven't met up till now, and you're with people that maybe you know a little bit. But hey, if we're all out of our comfort zone right now, that's good. That's good. God blesses us when we go out of our comfort zone for Him. So that's all of us. But why don't we start off now and just take a moment, brief moment of prayer. I know you probably prayed right before this video. If not, let's just ask the Holy Spirit for light and ask the Holy Spirit to be blessing everything that we're going to be doing for God and for each other over the next 6 weeks. So take a deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. And just ask right now, come Holy Spirit, come into this place, be with us, bless us, bless the person next to me, bless anybody who couldn't make it to the meeting today. Open our hearts to listen to your word, open our hearts to your truth, and give us all the answer deep in our hearts to the question that we're discussing today, who is Jesus Christ? Because Jesus sent you, Holy Spirit, to us, to our hearts. He sent it so that we could stay in touch with God, so that we could keep growing, keep loving, and live out everything that He came to tell us. And so we offer this prayer through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. So, chapter 1, if you've got your book already, then you know that chapter 1's pretty basic. One simple question. Who is Jesus Christ? Who is Jesus Christ? Like I said at Mass a couple weeks ago, if you were at the Mass I celebrated, what about the guy on the bus? The guy on the bus who says, why do you believe in God? Why do you believe in God? All right, you could come right back at him and say, well, why do you or why don't you? Because this question's for all of us. Who was or who is better? Jesus Christ, the most famous person in all of history, the only one whose statue you're going to see all over Yonkers, and you're going to know who it is. Not like the ones you drive by on South Broadway or North Broadway up by Untermyer. You drive by these statues, you don't even know who it is. Right? But as soon as you see one of Jesus, you know, oh yeah, that's Jesus Christ. He's the most famous person in history. Well, the guy on the bus who's asking you, who is Jesus Christ? What if you stop and say, okay, let's ask everybody on this bus, who is Jesus Christ? What are they going to say? Well, a lot of people are going to say this. Jesus Christ was a teacher. He was a good man. He was somebody I look up to, somebody I appreciate. And you know what? They're right. But when we say that, maybe we haven't read the gospel enough. Maybe we haven't read the Bible enough. Maybe we haven't gotten to know who Jesus was. Who was Jesus Christ? Because he says some pretty strange things, right? He says, I am the way and the truth and the life. John 14:6. You might have read it here in the book if you already read chapter 1. I am the way and the truth and the life. And no one comes to the Father except through me. Except through you? That doesn't sound like a good teacher. That sounds like somebody who's saying, I'm it. I'm the man. There is nobody else who's come before me and nobody else who's going to come after me who will lead you to God. Nobody else who will lead you to God other than Him. Nobody else will lead me to God other than Jesus Christ. Now, either the guy's insane, or he's a fraud, or he really is God, if you read that here in the book. But Jesus says that in so many ways all through the Bible. He comes up and says, look, you've heard that it was said, because there were things that Moses had said, there were things that were even written in the Bible. And Jesus says, you know what? I say to you. He's saying, that's true, but it's not the fullness of the truth, and here's what I say to you. And he says it over and over about so many different things. My Lord and my God, Apostle Thomas, after Jesus rises from the dead, he falls down on his feet and says, my Lord and my God. And Jesus doesn't say, whoa, where are you going? Slow down, boy. He says, Yes, I am your Lord and your God. Look, if Jesus says, I am the way and the truth and the life, and he's just a teacher, then he's wrong. How can he be my life if he's just a teacher? And if he's wrong, why should I listen to him if he's a teacher? He's either so much more than that, or he's nobody and we should just forget about it and go home. But if Jesus really is the way and the truth and the life, then the guy on the bus and you and me and everybody you've ever met and everybody who's ever going to be born, we have to know how to answer that question. The same question Jesus asked Peter. Matthew 16, the famous story. We have a picture of it here in this church in one of the stained glass windows. Matthew 16, Jesus asking them, who do people say that I am? And they give all these answers, the apostles do, and then he says, well, who do you say that I am? Because look, either he's God or he isn't. He can't be somewhere in between, and neither can any of us. Neither can any of us. But me, my day, my average day, my average week, I have to ask myself, hey, wait a minute, am I living right now like Jesus Christ is God? Am I living right now like he is my only hope? Like he is my only way to heaven? Like he is the only life I've got? Like he is the only truth? Or am I living like I'm a little bit of truth? Right? Because that's what sin is. Every time we sin, every time we're saying no to God, we're saying, I don't like your way. Or I don't want that life. I just prefer my own littleness, or my own death, or my own coldness. Or I prefer my own truth. Because either he's right or he isn't. He doesn't stop being God just because he asked me something that was a little outside my comfort zone or something I wasn't comfortable with or something that didn't seem fun enough for me at the moment. Jesus is my way, my truth, my life at every moment. And if I get that, then I get why I'm made for more. Because if he made me, if he has a plan for me, if his goodness is all for me, and if there's a future that I've got in him, this adventure of living in God that most of us never really get started on, if there really is more for me, if I'm made for more, well then these 6 weeks are going to be a really interesting adventure and a really interesting exploration as we kind of ask, okay, well if Jesus Christ really is God, then who in the world am I?